So we are Ambience Homes, and we're building houses anywhere at this point, you know, from $400,000 to $600,000, $700,000 houses. And what's really unique about us as a builder is that, and we've tried to diversify or make ourselves different and stand apart from our competition out there, is that really you can actually have an experience and a relationship with the builder and the project manager at Ambience Homes. So I know a lot of the builders, they're bigger companies, their owners of their company are completely inaccessible. With Ambience, you actually work directly with an owner of the company for the first part, and most of the second part you're working with my project manager. And as a team, we just build a great house for you. So one of the things that's really different about us, I think, is I do draw my own floor plans, or at least mock them up, and then sometimes send them out to a third-party architect, depending on the complexity and various things that are part of that. But for our customers, we have, you know, a variety of floor plans that you can choose from. We don't put a whole lot of them out there in marketing, because really we want to focus on the fact that we want to build your house for you. We want your floor plan, and we'll design it for you. If you don't have one that you bring to us, we'll design it for you, and then and we can work together that way to get you the house with all the parts and pieces that you want, not just your floor plan, but your cabinetry and your floor coverings and your doors and trim and your millwork and your you know, all of those things. At Ambience Homes, I mean, the sky really is the limit for the most part, and we try to keep it as much like that during the construction process as possible. So of course up front everything is, you know, you can change whatever you want pretty much in your build, and depending on what you change, of course it could cost you. But the fact is even during construction we're willing to make changes, and we have a lot of flexibility. We can move a wall, we can move a light fixture, we can whatever, and that's one of the things that you know, we are not a box builder, we're a custom builder. I think most of my third-party vendors and subcontractors would see us as set apart from a lot of the other builders. And number one, that we always pay our bills, and we pay them on time, and that's a huge thing. And clients may not understand how big of a thing it is, but there are builders out there that don't pay their bills. And you know, at the end of the day, the problem is the people who get the short end of that stick are not only the vendors and the subcontractors that work for that builder, but also the client ends up taking some responsibility for it. So one of the big things that is different about us, I would say, is that we pay our bills, we pay them on time, all of our trade partners are paid. And the other thing that they would notice different about us would be our commitment to quality. You know, we really do take pride in our work. Not only do we really want our customers to be 100% satisfied with their house, but we also got to walk away from that house feeling satisfied with that house, and quality control is a big part of that. We want to make sure that everything about that house meets our expectations. All of our homes currently are Energy Star homes. And so they're third-party verified, certified through energy incentives. And they come in and they do a whole bunch of tests on the house. They make sure it meets all sorts of different criteria. So it's, you know, the idea of Energy Star is it's supposed to be at least 15% above a code-built home as far as energy efficiency standards go. You could purchase a house built custom on one of our lots. Sometimes we have spec homes that you could purchase that are ready. Sometimes they're not ready. Sometimes they're only a month away from being ready. So that's one option. Another option is to build a home on one of those lots that I own currently, and in that case I can get the financing and build it for you the way that you want it done, and then at the end you close on the home and the loan and you buy it all from me at that point, like a typical construction process. Another one would be a custom construction loan, where the customer has the land in their name, and they go to the bank and they get a construction loan, and I'm the builder on contract to build with that construction loan, and the land never changes hands in that situation. So excise tax is kind of saved in that situation. So that can be a value to the buyer. But the requirement then is that they're getting the loan, and sometimes that process can take a little bit longer. A lot of customers don't realize that can be easily a 60, 90 day process on that loan, especially with appraisals, how far out they are currently. Another option would be is if you own that lot, you could always subordinate the lot to me so that my lender has the first right of, or actually it, the way that it works is that the land ends up going into the builder's name and the builder gets the loan on it, but you have the buyer, because they have an interest in that land, then they have a lien on the property in case of the builder's failure to complete the project. So there's lots of different ways you can do it, but really the builder, us as Ambience Homes, we've kind of been experienced with all those different ways, so it really just depends on your unique situation. And if you have a unique situation, bring it to us and we'll see if we can, make something work for you. One of the things that we offer on a lot of our homes, and we've been doing it on a lot of our homes, even though it's not required by code, our spec homes typically have had it, my own home, and my business partner's own home. We've put a product called Tech Shield in our homes, and that is, basically, it's the OSB, the underside of the roofing, the roof decking has a foil back on it. And it's faced with foil, and what it does is it reflects the sun's heat rays back, and it's actually cools the attic is cooled about 20 degrees less in the summer. So the majority of a home's heat loss goes through the attic. So you're conditioned. Air losses through the attic. And why is because you have a ceiling, and then on top of that you have a bunch of insulation. It's just loose fill thrown in their insulation in almost every build out there, unless you've paid for something custom. That's just how construction is done typically. And what happens with insulation is you really need to have an underside and a top side, and on the sides as well. It needs to be encapsulated for it really to do its job. So by code, we're required on a flat ceiling to do an R49. But really, that I don't know the exact translation, but the R value really isn't there because it doesn't have the top side on it. So by cooling the attic down a bit in the summer, it really helps with your air conditioning bill. Because your heat is so much dramatically less in the summer in your attic. Some of the different things that we're doing in our homes is we're putting in a lot of Bertazzoni appliances. They're kind of a mid-level of the high end, among Thermador, Wolf, Viking. They're kind of on the middle of the high end. And so we're putting in a lot of Bertazzoni appliances. You'll see those as you see some of the pictures of this home that we're sitting in. Most of the finish, well, all the finishes you see in this home were selected by me. So I would like to say that I have pretty decent taste on a lot of these things, and I'm totally willing to help work with the customers on some of their selections. But I do understand completely that everybody's different, and everybody's styles are different. And so while you may love this house for me, you may not love it for you. And so we have a team of design professionals that we work with to help fit your needs and find your needs fulfilled when you build your home with us. We've been using a new custom cabinet manufacturer. They're actually not new, they're from the Spokane area, and they have made a tremendous impact on our homes in the last year. We've been really, really happy with their cabinets. One of the things is they're just not a box cabinet. And since Ambience really leans toward the custom side of building, we really have enjoyed seeing the interiors of our cabinets be finished, custom sizes made to whatever you want, custom moldings. It's easy to put glass in cabinets, whereas before it wasn't. There's a lot of different things that you can do and a lot of different options you can do for lighting and different things when you have a finished interior that's a standard. Because, with some of the other cabinet manufacturers that we've even used in the past, you make a change to a glass door, and now all of a sudden your price not only went up by the glass doors, but it also went up by the fact that you have to finish the interior of your cabinet now, and then now you got to do glass shelves, and now you want to put lighting in, and it just there's a lot of things that every change, and a lot of customers don't understand that when you make one little change, oftentimes it affects a whole gamut of things. And so that's one of the things that as a company we've adopted, is the use of a custom cabinet manufacturer. The design person who works with the customer has over 30 years experience. I think it's right around 40 actually, of experience designing cabinets. He's old school and does it by hand. And then sends it off to the factory for, you know, more 3D type stuff that you can do with computer imaging. But the fact of having the custom finished interiors painted, if they're stained on the outside, they're stained on the inside. If they're painted on the outside, they're painted on the inside. It's not just a melamine product that is going to fall apart over the years.